Good morning, children. We are learning lesson 4, atomic structure. We will continue the lesson today. Till the last class, we learnt who all discovered the different subparticles of an atom and what are the limitations of their models. Now, we will learn the sixth point of this lesson, that is Bohr's model of atom. Now, Bohr, a scientist who has made a model for an atom, and it is a modern idea about the arrangement of particles within the atom. So the main postulates of Bohr's model of an atom, and we will learn today that first point, electron revolves around the nucleus in circular paths called orbits, or the other name of orbits are shells or stationary states. So an atom has nucleus. Around the nucleus, electrons revolve around the nucleus in a circular path. These paths are called orbits. So the different paths are there. Each path he has named it. So different orbits possess different energies. So this is the first orbit, that is known as K shell, and it has its own energy, and the second orbit will have different amount of energy. That is the second point. And the third point, so long as electrons revolve in a particular orbit, it neither emits nor absorbs energy. Therefore, the orbits are also called energy levels. The electrons revolve around the nucleus on its own orbits. When it revolves, it does not neither absorb energy or lose energy. And so that's why it is called the energy levels of an atom. So each orbit has its own energy level. So these energy levels he has named 1, 2, 3, and also the alphabet, that is starting from the nucleus. The first one is starting from the nucleus, number 1. And these numbers are called principal quantum numbers also. And these energy levels are designated as, these energy levels are given in name K shell, L shell, M shell and N shells. So each shell is also numbered, and that is the shell which is close to the nucleus is shell number 1. And the energy of an orbit increases. So each shell has its energy level, and when the shell numbers increases, the energy levels also increases as it moves away from the nucleus. The shell which is close to the nucleus has less energy, and the shells which are away from the nucleus will have more energy. So as many shells increases, that much energy also increases. When an electron jumps from one energy level to the other, energy is emitted or absorbed in the form of bundle of energy called quanta or photon energy, we call it. If an electron which is present in the first shell, and that is jumping from a shell to the other shell, so the jumping of the electron from one shell to other shell is emitted or absorbed in the form of bundle of energy. That bundle of energy is called quanta or photon, we call it. So what is photon? What other name of photon is quanta, and it is found in the atom, and the energy emitted when one electron jumps from one shell to other shell. So the energy of photon, that is E energy, is mentioned in the letter E is equal to, this is the energy which is equal to moving of one shell to other shell. So E2 minus E1. So E2, whatever the E2 has, the energy that will be minus from the energy of the first shell. So where E2 and E1 are the energies of the orbits in the final and initial states are respectively. So each shell has its own energy. So the energy where E2 and E1 are the energies of the orbits. When we are writing E2 minus E1, this E and E refers the energies of the orbits. When we are writing E2 means the energy of shell 2 and E1 means the energy of shell 1. So the first shell is named as K shell, second shell is named as L shell, and the third shell is named as M shell, and the fourth shell is named as N shell. So this is the atomic structure or made by Bohr. So Bohr's model of an atom, and it also tells us the energy levels of an atom, and this is considered as the modern idea about the atom. So this is still followed in the chemistry, and the other scientists, Rutherford and Thomson, they made also model of an atom. They are rejected because of some of the limitations. So this you have to understand and learn to draw this structure with proper names. So every atom, according to the modern idea, each atom has nucleus in the center, and around the nucleus electrons revolve in its own path. That path is called orbits or shells, and Bohr has named it as K shell, M shell, L shell, M shell and N shell. And in other way, in number, if you see, first shell, second shell, third shell and fourth shell. So each shell has its own energy also. Here we'll stop. The next part, that is point number 7, we will learn in the next class.